Can you tell me something about Rosa Parks?
Kendall Bradford has a yearly goal for her first grade classroom at Waukee Elementary.
I wanted our students and my first graders to understand that everybody has many parts to their story.
And that's the main focus of just about every single one of Mrs. Bradford's lessons, including February's Black History Month.
When we started with Martin Luther King Jr., I taught them how he was this big civil rights activist, but he's also a father and a college graduate and a husband.
All month long, students have added to this incredible display in the hallways of their school.
I want the kids just to really be able to see each other and celebrate things that are both the same and different.
First up is the color poem.
I wanted to incorporate the arts and how Amanda Gorman uses words to motivate and inspire others.
Pink by Eloise. Pink is strawberry sweet lemonade. Pink is for love and hearts. Pink is for strawberry ice cream. Pink is for watermelon. And pink is a ball gown.
Blue is the ocean. Blue is a blueberry. Blue is a crayon. Blue is the sky. And blue is rain.
Next to the color poems are the inspired drawings, coming from a lesson about Tyler Gordon and his incredible passion for painting and remarkable story.
So Tyler was born deaf, so he had a surgery, and he got some of his hearing back. And when he grew up, he had a stutter, and he's gifted with painting.
I had each of my kids think of somebody who inspires them. It could be themselves or their parents or just somebody that we have learned about.
I drew him because he was born deaf. And he's a very good painter artist, you can see right here.
I drew Martin Luther King Jr. because he changed laws.
And going home with students each night is their latest book, The ABCs of Black History.
E is for explore and education. Ray Jemison was the first black girl to go to outer space, and Ruby Bridges was the first black girl to go to a white school.
H is for Harlem, New York, a city for black creativity.
While Black History Month comes to a close Sunday, the lessons learned will stick with these students for a while, and their work around equity continues.
I want them to understand that they have power and their words have power, and that when I teach them about diversity and inclusion, that they understand that right is right, even if no one else is doing it.